Hi guys, welcome to our channel. In this video, we are going to see the ReactJS project. In this video, we are going to do ReactJS project. We are planning to do more projects in ReactJS to learn ReactJS as a fresher. It is very helpful for you guys, so that we have planned many things for you. So in that list, we are going to do CRUD project, okay, with the help of React only. Using ReactJS, we are going to build a super cool CRUD projects using React hooks. Okay, using React hooks, we are going to see how to develop a CRUD project in ReactJS also. See, like that, here many projects are there, okay. So I will show some samples, like I can show. Generally, CRUD means create, update, read, update, delete, okay. So the same thing I will take, we will type some inputs, okay, to do description, like that we can type. If you click this submit button, this list will become here. For example, I will tell something. Here one input box is there. Here one name we can type. If we click submit, that name will be come down. If we type another name here, that name will be come below. Okay, like that, one by one name we can type under submit, that will be come down. Okay, this is the create in here button, and that is great. If you read that, we can able to view that names, right? That is read. Here edit button is there, right? So if we click that edit, we can edit that names. So that is create, read, update. That is update. Here delete button is there, right? So this is delete. If we click that button, that name will be deleted. Like that, we are going to develop a React CRUD project. Okay. So I have created the scratch using npx create react app space project name. Okay, this is the super cool ReactJS project scratch. So here, from here, I just starting. Okay, I just deleting the existing things in our React project. In this app.js, app.css, I'm deleting those things. And this is the plain whiteboard we got it. Okay, from here we can start. This is such one ReactJS CRUD app using ReactJS hooks. We can delete this. Okay, so CRUD app using ReactJS tools. So this heading we can get here, and in the next line we can go, and we are going to create a input button. We are going to, so in this, the normal input tag, so that input button is coming. So we will style the input tag here. So here a input, we can style by giving height or 300px. No, not much. Sorry, I think 30px. So 30px, and width is like over 100px. So 100 is very small, so we can put 200. So width is 200, height is 30px. Okay, so this input box is ready for us. So inside we can type anything, like that, this normal input. Okay, for placeholder we can put here in the input, we can type the properties of input, like placeholder name. Okay, like name you can type. Okay, so here you can type anything, and I click the submit button, that will be come under, like that we can do. Here button, button, button. Okay, so this is like add name, like that. So I have put that button below. this button need to come below, right? This it works below this, this will be come, right? So here I will put some break br. If I put br, that add the button will be come down here, one br only there, right? So I just copy this, and in the next line also I will put this, so one more space I can get. So this is the simple input box and the button we was getting. So here button also we can do some styles. This is this button name, we can give some names, okay? Like I can put some ID for this, add name. This button name is we can put this by class name, okay? So we have created one class name for this button. This class name we will use for styling purpose, okay? So to style the input or tag the tag by class name, we need to put the dot and we need to put the class name, and here we can open the bracket and close the bracket, and here we can, so we need to style this button, right? Like what we can do, we can go to give some height, give width, and some background color and a text color, we can give some border radius, we can give lot of things we can give to style this, okay? I just to show you like height 25px, this button 25px, and width 75px. So with this is very less, okay? We need to give a little more, like 150 with this is more, so we put just 100, okay? So this is input button, this add button. So height was we will given, width is given, and we will give some padding inside, okay? This is border nearly coming, okay? So we will give some padding thing here, okay? Is not good actually. Okay, here we can, we was given, right? So that it is, so that this was came. Height we will not, we don't need height, just we given that width under padding, okay? So padding we can reduce little, 8, 6, 6, 6, so great. Padding 4, I think this is enough, I think. So we can give some background colors. Background color. Please come here. Here also we can change something. Okay. Make it not good. Blue, pink. This is also not good. Which color we can give? Not good. We can give some light colors. Okay, fine, this is enough. So we'll give some we'll change this text color, okay? How we can do this? Using color white. Okay, this is we can just increase this little bit. Background color, okay. I think this is enough. We can remove this border black coming in, so we can change the color also. Border color black blue, like this. We can change it actually. First, I will give something. So here it is gone, right? So, or you can give some color, or you can give none, like this we can give, okay? So or whatever you can give, like you can also give border none to remove that border. Okay, so whatever you need, that you can give. Okay, so next what we are going to do is okay, we'll see some styles, how we can achieve style. For that add button, green color is there. This is look good, and blue color also will look good. In blue color, yeah, blue color, this is little good actually. Padding 5px, and also we can give the button the edges are very sharp, right? That also we can reduce by border radius. Border radius actually 4px generally people will give. Okay, so this way we have same, right? So this is not a sharp edge, this will slightly indent. If we increase this by like I put a 40, so this will become like this. Okay, so like that we can edit. So commonly in buttons, if you hover, means this cursor this point cursor will be changed, right? Like a hand, this will become right hand icon. For now this normal default cursor only coming. So to change the cursor we can use cursor key. Okay, like cursor, if this is here, many styles are there, like these are the styles, many cells are there. Okay, but we need pointer, cursor pointer we need. When we hover this, pointer will become, pointer style will become here. Okay, so this is we need. And also one more thing also there, I just try it. Hover opacity 0.8. Wait, I will just try. Oh yeah, great. So like this we can see. Okay, in many website they will use this kind of things. If we hover, little change will be there. Okay, so this background color is changing. The opacity is, we have reduced. When hover, we have reduced that opacity. Okay, so button is there, when you hover, that is opacity. Okay, and also when hover, we can also change the color of the button, and height, width, border, all the things we can change. Okay, I will just show you color green, yellow green. When hover, this color will be changed. Okay, I just hover. Okay, not called color, background color we need to change, right? So background color, so hover, this button is changing background color, right? So like that also we can change the height, width, all the things we can change. Height we no need, width we will increase, like before we have given 100px, now I will give 120px. Okay, when hover this height width will be increased, and also we can like this we can put, and background color padding also we can increase, like padding before 5px, right? No, 6px. I just took hovering, so this change in height. So like that we can give green color, pick green. So this is good, right? So like this we can put some editing things in our project. This is a lot of things in with the React, HTML, CSS, all the things. Okay, so yeah, fine. So here we can type some name. Okay, Fiverr or Faisal, like that we can type some name. And if we click the tag name, that need to come below. Okay, that is our requirement. For that we need some state. Here we are typing right name underscore. If I click the tar name, we need to store that name in some place, right? The place is called state in our React project. So that we will how to create the state in a React project. So first we import import React from React. Import React from React. This basic one, okay? React. Here you need to put use state. This is one of the hook, okay? Use state. Use state is one of the hook in React. This is a inbuilt function in React, okay? With the use of this use state hook, we can create the we can create the state in our React project, and in that state we can add the names. Okay, we can add multiple names. First we can type a b c a person b person name. We can type and get submit, and the names will be come down. Okay, that all we are going to do now. Let's get started. How to create? You can need to just type here, and after that function you can type, okay, like const. I will just type syntax, just to make sure the syntax is correct, okay? Like in your project, type see that syntax is correctly here, and type this same thing in your project. Here we can put we need to put some name. In what name we can put all the names? Student names, name list, okay? Name list we can put. In this name we are going to store the all the data, okay? How we can update that how we can update this state? To update this state we need some function, right? So that for what function name we can give? Set name list. This name we can give, okay? With this name we with this function we will update this state, okay? So here we can put normal use state. Initially we will put some empty arrays, okay? With this empty array we can put in this empty array we will initially in this here we need to pass initial state, okay? So in the initial state whatever we can give. If a string means you can put double quotes or single quotes, or if you array, if you are creating the array means you put empty array, object means empty object you can put. This is our convenience, okay? So name list, I'm going to store the, all the names what are all typing here, okay? So here our placeholder is there, right? So in placeholder we need to take on change. One more, when we typing here that name we need to take, right? So that we will also create one more state, name set name, okay? Use state. This is string, okay? Whatever typing in the when typing we will store this name. After clicking this button we will take that name and put in this name list array, okay? Like that we are going to do. So this is name, right? So for this so value for this value we'll put name, okay? Value put name. And here on change, in on change we are getting that name whatever typing we can get here, okay? In on change we need to call one function and we need to update that, okay? Generally we will call the functions to make it easy. We can use like handle change. This is our function, okay? This function we will create here. Const handle change using here arrow bracket, here open curly brace, close curly brace. Here we can put e, okay? E1 we are getting, and here we can console dot log of e dot target dot value, okay? If you type anything that will be console here. If I type anything, this function will be triggered. In that when this function triggered, that value we can get this in console. Okay, I just right click and click the last button inspect and go to here console in the right side most tab. So I click console. Here you can see all the things. Okay, I am just typing Rahul, whatever typing here it is coming. Okay, that type whatever typing that we need to put in this state, right? So that we are inside this set, using this set name function, we will pass this the dot target dot value. So if we type the this we have console, right? This console names we have put inside the state. So that state we have passing when we're typing, we need to we are putting that e.target.val that name to this function. This this function will put that names to this variable. So this variable, where are that that variable we are assigning here? So that now if we type here, just clearing the console. If I type here R A H U L, that name is coming also here. And also coming here, okay. So like it is coming. So if we click this button, need to that need to come below. Okay, for that what we can do? So hit that below. Maybe we can put some empty spaces in below. And we can put name list. Name list we can put. Okay, below we can show all the names. Okay. Okay, so we will we are going to show like it will type. So if we click add button, that name need to be add in this state. Okay, so for that what we are going to do in that button is the right this button we are going to write one function. I just click enter to understand better for you. Okay, so here like whatever we did here, like the same thing we are going to do here, but this button, right? So that we are going to put on click. In on click we will need to write some function like add name. Add name, this is the function. Okay, this from add a name to list, add a name to list. So this function and copy this text, and with this text I will create one more function. Okay, con that name, this name came right. So we have created the function. Okay, so here what we need to do is we need to update that name to this name list array. So here we need to put like this set name list. We have created that function. Here what we need to put is the array, whatever already there that we need to put here, right? Dot dot dot, what already there, what are the names, name list, whatever name inside that name list already, like Rahul, Maya, like that, what are names will become already there, that will come here. After currently what name is here typing, that name need to come in the last, right? So that here it will be come. So this is the initial state and this is the updated value, whatever value you need to update, that we are passing. Okay, so here after we pushing the top, updating the name to this name list, we will just empty this name, like emptying that input button. Okay, so we have typed Rahul, right? So I just clicked the add name, so that it will be added in the name list, but we are not able to see now, right? So I just console that. I will put this console in here, console.log of this. I will put like name list. Okay, first Rahul is there, right? So first we have added that, is that name is coming. So just I am also adding Maya, and I just type clicking add name. So here you can see, right, this is Rahul Maya. So like this we can get it now, and also that is emptying also, but that will again come to the existing state. So whatever names we are adding here, we need to show that Rahul, my all the names in the below. Okay, in the below part we need to show. We will create some styles under that we will show, right? Okay. So. In the below name list. I can put just for first we will show that little the whatever there we will put that, then we can do style. Okay, so name list, in the name list array that is there, if name list dot name list under name list dot length is present, means whatever we need, we need to map that name list dot dot map and a name, or name already one state we have written it, so that we know if we use that will be confused for you. Okay, so I will take that in data or name also we can get it. Okay, so name username in this variable I can get it. Okay, whatever user variable you can put. Okay, so in this name we can get the data. Here we need to put like h2 or span we can put. Okay, initially we need to put this curly brace, in that you can type user. So now that state is empty, so now it is showing the list is zero. Okay, so if we type Rahul, I just click add name, that is coming here, right? Rahul and Maya, I click Maya and I click add name, that is coming one by one, it is coming, because this is span tag, right? Span mean inline, right? So that it is coming one by this is coming the same line. I will just show you by changing this as h3. I changed that span tag into h3, so you can see one by one. So this is also h3, so that we not able to find the difference between the this and the span size, so that I'm making this as h2. Okay, this is h2, and also I can put this underline. I think this will, I think this will work. So right here I will come. So you can identify this is nameless name is printing. This is one by one name is coming, okay? Just you can, for identification I put that say h2 tag and put that underline tag. Okay. And like that we can type any name, vni, add a name, that will come down, right? So like that we can get, yeah, we have achieved the create and read. We have created the name and we are reading. So create, read and is finished. C for create, that is finished. That is R for read, that is finished. So U means update and delete we will do. Okay, don't worry. Okay, so here near this we will put some button. Okay, so edit button we will put put this like we can make this. Okay, this is fine. We'll see button editing as the tag, we have put the edit button. Okay, so we need some spaces between that, like so that we can put in any ways. We can use many ways. I will change this into something different. Okay, so whatever we can put this in span tag and we can style this span tag, right? This very button we can put outside. So name and edit button is theme, right? So then we can edit the we can, okay, this is font of is enough, I think. Okay, font is enough. We need some spaces between this and this. So for that, what we can do means we will put for now we will put we can adjust, okay, then we can see. So this is edit button. For now we need some space, right? So that for button we need some space padding, margin left. I am just creating class margin left 5, margin left 5px. Okay, so I will put that for here, class name. So I just typing something and clicking it. So we can get some little space, right? Like this, we can. Then we can increase the space like 15. The space will be little big, okay? So like this, we can do. So that whatever we type here, this will become one by one below. Then we can edit. Also here many. Oh, this will need to give some more spaces between 1, 2, 1 each row. For that we can, what we can do is class name row, we can put, okay, this we can put in that row. For this class name, whatever we can put, padding or margin, can put like a top 5px 0px, this right side, bottom 5px, left side 50px. Okay, so now we can hope we can get some spaces. So we can get some spaces, right? In we have put padding inside each row, so that we are getting some spaces. Also we can put naming for numbering for this list. Okay, how we can actually mean in the username we are getting, right? So inside we can, as a second parameter, we get I, which is the type, we can get that numbering. So okay, simply we can put I plus. So here we can get that index only, array index means that it is starting from 0, 1, 2, right? So that it is showing 0. So that what we need to put is I plus 1, like that we need to put. So it will be so 1, 2, 3, 3 that we put. We need some dot, right, so that we can identify better. Yeah, this is good. This is good, right? What will become in one letter? Okay, this is coming in the center of the line. So what we can do means we can give some we can wrap this under some div. Okay, so this is name list component. In the name list we can put some styles like width is 500px. So we have, we can also put this, right? So this heading also need to come under these. Okay, so this whole bottom, okay, this is came here, right? We need to center this to here, and that need to come in center, right? So that what we can do is, for name list we need to put some styles, display flex. Okay, display flex that will be coming in the strike line. And then we need to put a flex direction column. Okay, that will be in column, that will be coming, like column it will be coming. So then justify content, we need to center. This will center our content to here. Okay, and also we can put align item center. If we put this need to come in our center place. Justify content center, align item center. Okay. And we have wrapped this, right, so that it is coming like this. We will wrap like this. Okay. I think this will work. This need to work actually. Okay, fine. How we can. Another option also there. Like what they given means left 50%, like that also will be achieved. That also will be achieved. Left side we can get space. Okay. Wait, we will remove this. We will check. Name list with 500px, left 50%. Okay, what we can put means position relative left 50%. So this will be come go there. Okay, so what we can put 30%. Yeah, okay, fine. We need to put in center, right? Yeah, directly below that is coming. Okay, yeah, cool. So what am I typing now? This will be added here. This will be come here. Okay, so what we each row is the right row. For that row also we can put some styling, so like display flag, justify content, space between, like that we can give, right? So this is 500px is more there, 300px. yeah, okay, this is enough. So we need to change the space again. 30 40. Actually this is not a good thing for styling to wear this person that you left. For now I am putting this. Okay, in that final we can change or do something for this. Okay, for now we will just concentrate on the functionalities on the view layer. Okay, so what is coming in that array we can get, right? If we first the array to all the data we are getting. Okay, fine. So if we edit, that name need to come here. Okay. So in that edit button we need to write some functions. We will write I will just enter and make it easy for read purpose. For on click button this is right. So edit name I am just a passer. Edit name I am just creating one function. Here we need to pass that index in which name we are editing. That need to we need to find, right? So that I am passing that I index here. In this name I will create const edit name on this thing. Okay, so here I am passing that index we are getting. So I just show you what is index, what is coming here in console. So this is zeroth index, right? So that if I click this zeroth index, that is coming. If I click this first index coming, if I click this first index, this click is zero index, first index. So that index we can get. With this index, we can edit this item. We can find that name, which name this is, that we can get it, okay? Then what we need going to do, means okay. Here with that index we need to find and set it in. Okay got it. Here we can continue. Like we have find that index, right? If we need to find that name list, name, what name is that, that we need to find that name and save it in name variable. Like that also we can do, or else we can do directly also, okay, that is make a little more easy for that learning purpose. Okay, so here I'm directly passing this name. Here I'm taking name directly, like a username. I'm taking as a username. Okay, just I'm just clicking this FDFS, that is coming. FFS, this is this big name. Whatever you are clicking edit, that name will be kept. Okay. So we can with this we can achieve using edit function. We get that ID name. Here what we need to do is we have get that name, right? So that then we need to update this state using this function. So set name, whatever we get in the parameter, username. So the username we have get, right? So if I click this, what I click that, right? Those is coming here. I just refresh and show you there in first. Okay, this is I type Rahul and I click add name here. Navin admin. If I click edit, that name is coming, came here. Okay, so if I click add, that will be added. So if I click Navin in the line, if I edit, that name is coming here. Okay, so here we can edit. So this is the basic functionality. So if I click edit, that name is came back. So if I click add, that will be coming newly. Okay, newly coming, because that is this when clicking this button we have just added, right? What need to come, the previous list names need to come, whatever in the current in input, that will come in the last, so that it is coming like this. Okay. So we need to update that, we need to update that particular list. Okay, so that what we need to do main. Okay. So add a name is edit. Okay, got it. Add a name list. If index present name, we can do this. If present means we need to do that, or else we need to do this. Okay, got it. We need to pass here the index also. Okay, so index also we will get. So we here we will get that index, right? So we'll create some more one state. This is edit index. This is set edit index. Set edit. index. Okay, so here this is like this empty only. Okay, so in set edit index we need to update that while editing edit name index. So when clicking where added name to list, when clicking this, that first we that need to check whether that edit index is present or not. If edit index is present, it means that need to come here and we can create some temporary variable. In that name list we can spread that name list. Okay, name list we can spread it, and in that that will be that all the name list will be there, right? So here what we can do is temp dot splice of that edit index, actually that is our name edit index comma 1. Okay, so that will be edited there, and that need to that we will need to check, right? Or set name list, here we can put this. Okay, like that we can do. Else in the else part we can put this, so this need to work. And after this, after adding this, the set edit index also need to put empty, make it empty. Okay, we'll just try. Raghul add name, it is name. Deny add name, it is name. So I made it deny. I am just adding yes. I just click add. Okay, in the first index it is showing. Is updating. Wait. So here we need to do this place method. Okay. Edit index place. Okay. We need to refer anything like. Splice, we can we can do that edit operation. Jan Fib. Okay. I think I got it. Using splice method, first parameter is in which index we need to insert. 0 means that you think that is add, and that in the what name we need to add, that we need to put in the last page. Okay, first is index we need to put. Here our index is edit index, that is our main index. Next 0 means if we add means we need to can put 0 like that. Okay, so what name variable we need to add, that is in that last variable. So now we will check when I Raj. So we click Raja, I make it Raja. I get it here. That index is edited, but also again it is coming new also. Why? It also entering into this, I think. But I don't know why it is this. I just edit Raja into Raj. Change and edit. Okay, it is coming here. But the cold is coming here. This is common thing. Okay. Edit. So index is correct. The 0 alpha, okay, correct on my thing. Insert chart index 1. Okay, that index 1. 0 slice replace one element at the index 4. This index only. In this index we are updating this part only we are coming. Start delete count 0. These are the items we are going to add. Start it is doing correct, but also it is updating. I think it is going temp. I think now we will try. It is working Rajan, but also it is adding the name, the first name it is adding. Like this we will face some issues in between. Okay, so we need to solve these challenges also. We can get it the old one. In that we have added temp.splice. In that we have added temp. Here we are updating the thing, and have added. This will be go to here. We'll try it. Okay, Rajama. Rajesh Sadi. I'm not like you. I don't like this. But likes me. What? Edit index present means we need to add update here. Edit index set name list else. Whether that is coming inside this, I think this is add. Add is called in, I think. Rajan, I'm making Raja, it is changed. Nameless. This is not. This is not getting here, but inside this, it is updating. Temp.splice. We'll check this by here itself. Okay, we need to debug and we'll check console that log of 10. What we are doing, we are doing edit now. We now add. If I click add, that will go to add. Why it was added? Okay. I click edit, I just organize, I click in add names, but it is going to inside, yeah. Oh, because we are not, this is we can put this, okay. React.js add me, cannot read properties, no. What is the method for the create? First name is E, okay. Second name is E. First name is 1. So 1 is coming as new. And boosting editor, right? Duplicate is adding, we need to also avoid duplicate, okay. So for avoid duplicate, add a name list. When coming here, we need to put some one condition, like if name equal to empty means that need to return null, okay, so that it will not add empty duplicate list. So then Raj we have added, so this was added. Raj we have clicked, so Vinay is added. So I just click edit, Vinay is, it's not updated, why? Yeah, oh, we have put this so that it is not updated, but I think splice this is correct only, but it is not updating. Edit Raja, it is newly written. When I click, wait, I need to clearly see this edit index. Edit index, we have controlled edit index, also we make this name also. So for we are editing this for, so name is for this, correct. Name list, this is for this, correct. 0 1 2 3, this index also correct, okay. So till this it is correct. If I click add again, it is added. It is added, fine. Again I click, I will just make something else and I click this. It is not added because of this I not put this, but okay, if I click this coming. Just adding, but also one more new line is coming. I don't know why this is coming. Fur. I think this function calling twice, I think. Console.log add a name function. If refresh, it is coming. Clicking editing, I'm just clicking. Add a name function. Add name function, it was called only once. This is index also correct. So already 7. Okay, you tell this correct. So I click this. This is also editor. This was came add name function was one time called. This is a total array name list edit index. Which line? 40th line. Oh, edit index is empty, so that is coming showing like this. Name is edit index is not present. If edit index is not present, then there will be add like that. We can do means we can do in time. Another one, status set edit status. Okay, generally there will be add. Okay, add, the default status will be add. So when clicking edit me, index also need set edit status will put edit. Okay, so after this I will again change this to add. So here what we can put means meters equal to edit only need to come, else there need to come. Okay, edit index 22 edit index. Okay, we can make this as it is. We are editing this. For update we need to find something. Anyway, CRUD update react.js hooks, so we need to refer something. I'll see and make it easy for you, so that it is so you can easily understand. Post data is a router. I think we have a look at it. Adding a user like that whatever we did that we are using here. Okay, init user handle change name value, set user, init user. Okay. Edit and delete they are doing delete by this method. Okay. That ID not equal to okay. Delete users. Edit user form. While editing. While editing handle change props at current user, set user, handle change in name value e.target. Okay, already this also I think it will not work for us. This guy is used in different method. Change state update user name array. Okay, array they are pushing. Okay, here the decision array, that new array getting this. Okay, this is also okay. Here component analysis management. Numbers we are using CRUD here. We are editing this edit index, it is coming. Here is admin ID. Okay, it is coming. Edit means set user details. Already coming. We need to find that index and we need to update that. Submit. Name, email, phone number, place, status, add the details. Name is status add means can directly add. Okay, if edit means we need to item ID filter. User details filter item or ID not equal to ID. Hold down one thing, maybe remaining things will be editor details update, editor details update, editor details. Okay. That will be come one place and it will be there. This place method one thing was there, right? CRUD
React handle submit say to meet in types or who is not present or this is to me other thing set this is only they have done edit index make value is present will submit order okay edit index edit index if edit index present if edit index edit index edit index present means I can get the temp from temp dot slice edit index comma one comma okay well, let's see. Yeah, it is working. Sorry, guys. 5. This is we are editing, okay? 2. Whatever editing that is coming. Why here it was wrong? Here it is showing 0, then only show that I have 4. Okay, this is for adding purpose only. For we are doing replace so that on the second index 1 only comes. For add only 0 need to come. So if we are replacing 1 need to come. Okay, got it. So I think all are good now. So Rahul, add name here, it is coming. Vinay, Raj. I just click Vinay and I click Vina. It is editing here. This I click editing here. Raja. Add a name. It is coming. It's like this. Rahul G. It is coming. Add a name. Okay. Like that, we can do edit button. We can do all edit. Okay. Then what we are going to do is so we have completed create, read, update. So remaining delete only we have. Okay. So delete functionality is only we have. We can complete this easily. Okay. Delete is not much very difficult. Delete is very simple. For delete what we can see means we can have read like that. We can need to put some delete button. So this is coming, right? What do we do with our long name? Okay, like that it will be super key. Okay, fine. So delete means that it will be deleted. For delete we need to delete. Here we need to pass I think this is enough. Delete name. Okay. For delete const delete. Here we have get index read. From index slice where temp equal to the dot name list temp dot
slice, slice. You are edit index. So index comma 1. Here this thing. Let default. I think like this will be come. Set name list. We'll see. Why what happened? Buddy, hey. Raj Venu. So if I click edit, all the things gone wrong. Okay. Slice tutorial. Okay, just we'll see. We got that index. With that index, just we need to remove that index only, buddy. I think temp dot slice. We are updating the using splice method also we can do. Okay. Splice method result index, that index one means that it will be delete. Okay. Here what index need to delete, how many thing need to delete, that is the thing splice. So I just put in here. Okay, now we have Raj Kiran. I just delete this Kiran. Kiran, I just delete data deleted, T deleted. Yeah. So successfully we have done the top reasons, okay. Like CRUD app using react.js hooks, we have successfully after many struggles, problems, we have successfully solved this. Okay. Hope you have understood. For now the all functionalities are completed. Okay, now we will concentrate on the style. We will style this, okay, so that it will be looking nicely, right? So that how we can style, we will show some examples. Just we see this, we will see. One second, I will just take a look at these pages. Actually style is we can do in many methods in react.js. like with a CSS also we can design, CSS also we can use sources, lists, any things are there. For now we need some standard design. We need to design very attractive design we need to do. First a heading. CRUD app using react.js hooks. Add name. Or we can put border also, like name list. If we can, we can write. So here we can put border 1px solid black. Yeah, border complete. So here we can type Rajul 9. So we need some padding inside this, right? So padding 20px. Okay, padding. Background color. Background color. Background color. This button we can see. For edit button. Edit button. Usually we will put edit button green color and that is red plenty. So that we get if we are using this, okay, this color we will change later. For edit button we will put some color, okay? Like BG, we can put some names, class name, edit button. Dot background color green. Okay, green will style very cool, cool color white and some padding. Padding 10px. No, 4px. Okay, 4px. Top and bottom, inside left and right, it beats. It is not fine. Okay, and border also no need. We can use that hovering and for hovering we have used color, right? Better I think we can use this color. It is good, right? So cursor pointer we need to put. Cursor pointer we can put and edit. For delete we can put before that time. Okay, we'll put the same thing for delete button. Delete button. We'll use this for this class. Okay, just we need to change the color of delete button. Delete means red, right? Yeah, this is red or this is red. That is fine. Or you can put red
Yeah, this is also fine. And this over, let us show. Okay, I think this is fine. So edit or delete. Also, one more thing. Whenever we refresh surface, that the mouse will be automatically need to come here. So for that input, we can use like autofocus. I input, we will pass the properties. Autofocus. Okay. So just now I refresh it. So here you can see the mouse automatically will go there. Just refresh it. Automatically mouse will go there. That we can deselect type. Okay. Okay guys, till if you are watching this video till this like, subscribe and comment guys. Okay, this will help us to do more projects, more learnings for us. Okay, and also we'll create some Telegram groups, join in that groups as well. It is helpful for you guys to get all the tutorial videos, all projects in react.js, backend.js, a lot of things we are going to learn now. Okay, so this is most benefit for you. Comment. Okay, interesting. We'll see how it will be looks like if you see this sort of form. Yeah, it is like nice, but I think here no need this much space. I think above name is tag. I think this I don't know why that much space is coming. Nameless. Okay, that's fine, no problem. We'll see later. Okay. So what else we can do here? This is enough for this video thumbnail, right? This will attract, I think. We will put from this border thickly so that it will be great. Input, we need to do some border 2px only green. Button focus should border. Yeah. input if you smart enough. 4px. How it will look like. This button color, we can increase the size also, like edit button, right? Edit button padding top 5 20, like border radius also we can give border radius 4px. Here also can give 80 25. Right. 4 letter is enough. Subs. First letter no need. And this color we will change. Input. This button name also, add a name, padding 8px, 10px, how it looks like now. We need to bold this also a little bit. Each row, right? So here we can give font size 20px, font weight 500px. Add a button over also, that padding it will come the same rate. Padding, oh, the same padding. Input also, that font size need a bigger. But here the we need some padding a little bit. Okay, heading now it is better. I think that it's in focus, I think. Border color. Okay, while while focusing it is showing blue color, like come. Okay, this is like subscribe comment. Okay, how this look like? This font is also in increase font weight for buttons. This button also we can edit, add in new button. Okay, I think now it's good. Okay, we can remove little 35 38. This is good. Also we can delete unnecessary things like this one. Either this is no need, I think. The status we can, with edit index also we can. Okay, if edit index present means like that, we can if to set edit status is less. I will check whether now it's working. Is working, but it is too lengthy, right? So that it will be enough. This is enough. So delete also working, delete also working. Yeah, good. Also, what we can do is here we are showing, right? If you are doing mini count means it is showing like this, right? So for this we can see something like user dot dot length greater than 4 means greater than 5 means user name dot slice of 0,4 else user name. Like this we can put. Okay, greater than 5 means, well, let me check this. Ok, block is going out of the border. For that I am telling like this. If a dot on length greater than 5 means for that slice of undertaking this. Substring. Oh, okay. There is substring. Of 0 something like that, I think that is wrong syntax. Now if you need dot software can put like this. Okay, dot slice of count dot length greater than count of dot product rtb rtb. So it is working. Why it is not working for us? This is correct method, you know why? Hey, bhaiya. Hey. Actually, I think Zedit is not working. As I expected. Edit index. Before it was worked, right? What happened, bhaiya? Oh, now it is working. Okay, I think it is working, but working. Okay. Username dot length greater than 5 or this no substring, but yes, sub str also something there. I think we need to put like this bracket. Yeah, got it. Yeah, Rama, yeah, we achieved this. Ra. Add. Yeah, coming. It is great. I forget it. In plus. Dot. This button. If ROM means 23 letters, right? So that will become here. If you ask doing comment, means it is more than, right? So that is, there will become the first 4 letters will become, remaining part will be come here. Like this, it we can execute, okay? Oh my god. Yeah, we have achieved successfully. Edit, delete, style, functionality, follow, coming perfectly. I think this is enough. anything we can do here? Anything more we can do here? Actually, like position relative something I want to create. This will generally not put, and this also will generally not put. Okay. So what we will put means here we need to put display flex. Just we contain. Item center. Hey bhaiya, come down. Flex direction. Some column. Yeah, it is great, right? So this only need to come in center. So far that we can put this empty, or we can put dot excellent center. What I mean yeah, now it's working. Change this update button. While doing update, there is need to show update, right? Derivated in the guys, I think it is great. Okay, thank you guys. If you like this video, like, comment, share with your friends, do a lot of things. Okay, all the best guys. Will see you in the next video. Thank you, bye bye.